Hello students, in this video I am going to talk about the demultiplexer, which is an example of combinational logic circuits. Let us start. Introduction. A demultiplexer, which is basically commonly known as DMUX, performs the opposite function from a multiplexer. In the last video I have discussed everything related to the multiplexer, that how it works. So what is a demultiplexer? It is going to perform the opposite function from a multiplexer. It switches data from one input line to two or more data lines, depending on how many select lines we have. As you can see it over here, first of all, it is denoted by 1 cross n. Why 1 cross n? Because the number of input signals are fixed, which is equal to 1. Whereas we can have n number of output signals over here. But how many output signals will be there? It totally depends upon how many select inputs, select lines we have taken over here. So the formula for the calculation of how many select lines will be there, depending upon how many outputs we require, is 2 raised to power of m is equal to n, where m is the number of select lines we have, n is number of output signals we have, and a is our input signal. As you can see that in the last video, I have taken n was equal to number of input signals, because that was n cross 1. So that is the only difference between multiplexer and demultiplexer block diagram. The applications. So here we have taken an example of 1 cross 4 demultiplexer. So this is a single input signal, single source. A computer is available with us. Depending upon the select lines, 00011011, our output is going to be divided in 4 options, 4 parts, D0, D1, D2, D3 over here. So when the select lines are 00, the output will be transferred across the laser printer. When the select lines are 01, it will be transferred across the fax machine. When the select lines are 10, it will be transferred across the color inkjet printer. And finally, when the value of select lines is 11, it will be transferred for the pen plotter. So this is how the application of demultiplexers are going to work. Let us discuss the first type of demultiplexer that we can have, the basic demultiplexer, 1 cross 2 demultiplexer. Make sure students that you just concentrate on this portion. Whether mentioned demultiplexer or not, just concentrate on this. If the number of input signals are 1, that is an example of demultiplexer. And if the number of output signals are 1, that is an example of multiplexer. So let us start the block diagram first. This is the block diagram of 1 cross 2, means 1 input signal A and 2 output signals Y0, Y1. And what about the number of select lines? Let us discuss the same formula once again. 2 raised to power of M is equal to N, where M is the number of select lines we can have and N are the number of output signals. So by concluding these values, the number of select lines comes out to be equal to 1. So here S0 is the only one select line that we have used in our block diagram. So next is the truth table and the Boolean expression for that. As right now we have just one select line, so I have taken S0. Both the options I have mentioned, 0, 1, because with the help of one input signal we can have two options, either 0 or 1. But now the difference comes over here. In earlier case in multiplexer, we have just taken one output signal Y, because the output was just 1. But in demultiplexer, right now we are having two output signals. So we have to talk about both the output signals over here. The first output signal is Y0, second output signal is Y1. So when the select line is 0, the input will be collected across Y0. And when the select line is 1, the output will be collected across Y1. The another difference between multiplexer and demultiplexer. In multiplexer, I have just discussed a single Boolean expression. Once again, the reason is going to be there because in multiplexer, we have just one output. Whereas in demultiplexer, we are going to have multiple different outputs. So for example, in this case, two outputs are there. Hence, two Boolean expressions will be mentioned. Let us start. Y0. So how to write down the value for Y0? When S0 is 0, 0 means S0 bar. So the signal is S0 bar dot A, that is Y0. And Y1, S naught dot A. Why S naught dot A? Because the value of S naught is 1 when Y1 is equal to A. So this is how you can write down the Boolean expression. Next is logic circuit diagram. Again, students, make sure to compare the logic circuit diagram with the block diagram that we have just used. Let me draw a block over here, because inside the block we can have any different type of logic circuit diagram. So now let us compare. One input signal, true. One select line, true. Two output signals, true. So this is okay, that the logic circuit diagram we have designed is actually representing 1 plus 2 demultiplexer. Now let us discuss the connections over here. Earlier I have told you Y naught is equal to S naught bar dot A. So you can see it over here. S naught bar dot A. Dot means AND gate. Whereas the value of Y1 is S naught. So you can see this is S naught. So S naught dot A. So I am repeating this point once again, which I have already discussed in the video of multiplexer. First of all, we take the select line as it is, as you can see it over here. And then you take the same select line through NOT gate, which will represent the select line bar. Here the example is S NOT bar. So this will help us to design the logic circuit diagrams in a very easy manner. So right now we have two output signals. And please do not connect any OR gate in demultiplexer logic circuit diagram, because we have two separate output signals over here, Y0 and Y1, in the example of 1 cross 2 demultiplexer. So next is 1 cross 4 demultiplexer, students. So one input signal, four output signals, Y0, Y1, Y2 and Y3. So how many select lines are going to be there? The same formula, 2 raised to power of m is equal to n. Now n is equal to 4, which can be also written as 2 raised to power of 2. Hence, the number of select lines will be 2, S1, S0. So these are the two select lines which will be used for the implementation of 1 cross 4 demultiplexer. Next is the truth table and Boolean expression. So now, two select lines. So we can have four combinations, 20, 21, 01, 01. And as in 1 cross 4 demultiplexer, we have four output signals. So that is why I have mentioned all the four output signals over here in the truth table. First is 00, Y0 is output, 01, Y1 is output, 10, Y2 is output, and 11, Y3 is output. Again, four Boolean expressions will be mentioned, as we are going to have four separate output signals. First is Y0. So Y0 is A for 00. 00 means S1 bar, S0 bar dot A. Next Y1, S1 bar, S0 dot A. Next is Y2, S1, S0 bar A. And the last is Y3, that is S1, S0 dot A. So these are the four Boolean expressions which are representing the four output signals Y0, Y1, Y2 and Y3. And the last is logic circuit diagram for 1 cross 4 multiplexer. Again, students, I have taken both the select lines, S1, S0. This is the normal select line that we have, and that is through the NOT gate, which will represent here S1 bar and here S0 bar. And this is the input signal, because we have just one input signal over here. So let us compare all these signals with the block diagram. One input signal, true. Two select lines, true. And four output signals, true. Hence, all these connections, or we can say the signals, are exactly same as we have used in block diagram. Now let us discuss the connection. First is Y0. So we have S0 bar, S1 bar, A. And dot is available in all the three variables. Dot means AND gate. And in any AND gate, we can have n number of input signals. So here I have taken 3 input AND gate. Next is Y1. So what is the value for Y1? 0, that is S1 bar, 1, that is S0 dot A. Next is Y2. Y2 is S1, S0 bar A, and last is Y3, which is S1, S0 A. So this is logic circuit diagram of 1 cross 4 demultiplexer. Now the last example which I am going to discuss is 1 cross 8 demultiplexer. So 1 cross 8 means 1 input signal, 8 output signals starting from Y0 till Y7. And the same question again, that how many select lines will be used for that? And the answer for that is 3 by 3, because 2 raised to power of 3 is equal to 8. And we have total number of output signals to be equal to 8. And the 3 select lines will be S2, S1 and S0. Next is the truth table. So 3 select lines will have total 8 combinations, 4041, 2021 and 0101. This is how you can write down the whole truth table with the help of S2, S1, S0. Now again students, I have mentioned all the 8 output signals that we can have starting from Y0 till Y7. So 000, Y0 is output, 001, Y1, 010, Y2, 011, Y3, 100, Y4, 101, Y5, 110, Y6 and 111, Y7. And at the same time instant, all the remaining output signals will be equal to 0. That means we are not going to get any output signal across the remaining output signals. Next is the Boolean expression. But before showing you the Boolean expressions, I am going to discuss with the help of truth table first. So first is Y0, because right now we will be writing down total 8 output Boolean expressions starting from Y0 till Y7. So first is Y0, that is S2 bar, S1 bar, S0 bar dot A. Then Y1, S2 bar, S1 bar, S0 dot A. Next is S2 bar, S1, S0 bar dot A. Next is Y3, S2 bar, S1, S0, A, Y4, S2, S1 bar, S0 bar, dot A. Next is S2, S1 bar, S0, dot A. 6 is Y6, S2, S1, S0 bar. And the last one is Y7, that is S2, S1, S0, dot A. Do not forget to add dot A with all these functions, because the output will be collected across the respective output signal value Y0 till Y7. So just see the Boolean expression which I have just told you. S2 bar, S1 bar, S0 bar, A. S2 bar, S1 bar, S0, A. S2 bar, S1, S0 bar, A. S2 bar, S1, S0, A. S2, S1 bar, S0 bar, A. S2, S1 bar, S0, A. S2, S1, S0 bar, A. And the last is S2, S1, S0, A. And you can easily write down all these things with the help of just concentrating on this number, 0. 0 will be written as 0, 0, 0. So 0 will be represented as bar. 1. What is the equivalent value of 1? 1 is 0, 0, 1. So you can see 0 means S2 bar, 0 means S1 bar, and 1 means S0. So this is how you can easily write down the Boolean expression for any random multiplexer and demultiplexer. Now the last is logic circuit diagram. Here I have taken input signal A, because we have just one input signal, S2, S1, S0, and with respect to same I have taken S2 bar, S1 bar, S0 bar. And the AND gates that will be used over here will be 4 input AND gate. The 3 inputs will be from the 3 select lines, and the 4th input will be from input signal A. First is 000 dot A. Then we have 001 dot A. Then we have 010 dot A. Then we have 011 dot A. 4. 4 means 100 dot A. 5 is 101 dot A. 6 is 110 dot A. And finally the last Y7 is 111 dot A. Here 1 represent the select line as it is, for example S2, S1, S0, and 0 represent the bar signal, that means S2 bar, S1 bar or S0 bar, depending upon the truth table that I have just discussed. Also students, you can put the comment section and you can ask me the topics in which you are facing doubts so that I can help you for those topics as well. Thank you so much.